Oh, my name is Olga Reiche. I have a German name, but I am 100% Guatemalan. My grandfather was German, and he married a Kekchi woman from the area where Amalia is from. And I think since then I have it on my blood, the textile from that area, because I love it. And in long time ago, I started working for development projects, and I started traveling around Guatemala, and then I started falling in love with all the textiles and learning about them. And so learning also, after the earthquake in 76 in Guatemala, there are a lot of groups started working with crafts as a development or getting some income for themselves. And so a lot of groups of Guatemala started forming. And so I got to know them through that organization that I was working. And so along the years, I've been working with them in different ways and trying to help them in developing products and also in acquiring or looking for markets for them. And Yolanda is from Sololá, from a village called Chuacruz. And I met her when she was like 8 years old with her mother. Her mother and 8 women more founded a group for widows. They were widows from the repression, from the war, the civil war in Guatemala. And so they started this group for weaving, and they've been mainly to give education to the children.
Red. It's such a dominant, beautiful color in your work. Can you talk a little bit about that and your blouse and you know what how that is you know related to Sololá? I think so.
Entonces, en el caso tuyo, el rojo. Mm-hmm. En Sololá se usa mucho rojo.
Sí.
¿Por qué el rojo y los motivos de la blusa de tu huipil y esto? ¿Si nos puedes decir algo?
Bueno, nosotros tiene otros significados en la ropa y el corte. El huipil tiene mucho rojo porque tenemos como humanos nuestras venas tienen sangre, entonces representamos la sangre más que todo. Y los y estos caspiados es la serpiente, porque tiene dos colores. Y también los adornos, en la naturaleza hay muchos árboles, entonces eso también tiene los dibujos.
She said that red because it's what we have in our veins, it's blood, and they like it because of that. And also in the Icat that they are using, it's because it's like the serpents and two colors. And the motifs that they use here in the brocade, it's mainly from the trees, many trees in nature.
Y también tiene el ichikaku, el hilo natural, porque siempre los abuelos, siempre ellos utilizaron lo que es el algodón natural, no compraron así hilo fabricado o ya hecho, sino que ellos mismos lo hacían con sus propias manos.
And we also use the brown cotton, that's also from our ancestors, because they didn't have any commercial trade, and they didn't buy any commercial trade, but they used to spin it and use it. So it's a very important.
So can you talk a little bit about brown cotton and what, you know, what that means, and is it, you know, is the cotton just of a brown color so that you don't dye it? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Que si le puedes contar algo sobre el ishkako, algún significado que tenga, por qué lo usan así, porque no les gusta teñirlo, sino que les gusta natural.
Bueno, el ishkako representa más la tierra porque es de color café, entonces eso lo que significaba para ellos. y no lo usan más así como natural porque es un material que no le hace daño a la persona porque no tiene químico, por decirlo así. Entonces es por eso que ellos siempre les gustaba usar el algodón.
It's been traditional to use the brown because it's like the color of the earth, and also no chemicals on it, so it's very nice for the body, and use it in the clothes.
Sí, de verdad que muchas gracias por la oportunidad que dieron a mi cooperativa, a la asociación, porque sabemos que en Guatemala hay mucha competencia sobre nuestro trabajo, entonces allá casi no se vende. Entonces, ya que aquí nos dieron la oportunidad, pues las mujeres están muy felices y agradecidas con ustedes, y porque hay muchas mujeres que tienen necesidad, hasta algunas están estudiando sus hijos y no tienen dinero para ayudarlos. Entonces, con la ayuda de ustedes puede llegar un poquito de dinero para sostenerse. Entonces, estamos muy agradecidos con su apoyo, con todo lo que han dado por nosotros.
Well, she said she thanks the opportunity that she has in this market, because in Guatemala there are a lot of competition on the products and not too much appreciation on the products too. So here she found it, and she thanks for the opportunity, because many of the members of the cooperative don't have the children in the school, and they need the money for that, and so they need the markets.